guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I filmed like this instead of just sitting down, but it's been a while. For today's video, I wanted to show you a full, proper kind of boat tour. Even though we have such a tiny little boat, it's mostly like a canoe with a sail. I wanted to do this video mostly for ourselves in the future, but also because when we first got the boat, we had absolutely no idea. We had no idea what we were looking at when we thought about buying it. We had absolutely no clue how to rig it together, like put the boom on, put the mast up, put the sails on, like no idea. The entire process of learning how to sail, not only like actually learning how to sail, but to put together the boat, was such a trial and error. It's like, oh, well, this looks like it should fit type of thing. So I kind of wanted to do that video for anyone that has a similar boat like we have. But also, I just want to have these kind of memories for in the future when we no longer have this boat. So if you found this video hoping to find kind of like instructions on how to rig up the boat, I will put a little timestamp right here so you can just like skip ahead if you don't care about anything I'm about to say. We have officially put Little Button up for sale. So we bought Little Button at the end of February, and all through March we did like land sailing and just watched videos and kind of learned some terminology, points of sail, how to sail, like wind direction and all of that. And we kind of just like played in the driveway, putting up the mast, figuring out where all the nuts and bolts and stuff kind of go. And then we started actually teaching ourselves how to sail by trial and error in like April. So we're just gonna be busy. He's gonna be gone, I'm gonna be busy, and then we move next summer. It mostly just depends where we're moving next of what boat we're getting, but if, most likely if we do stay in the lower 48, then we will get a McGregor 26X. That's pretty much our favorite boat at the moment. We also love, I don't know, we love a lot of boats. It's kind of sad to get rid of Little Button. We've only had it for a few months, but you know, it did its job. It taught us how to sail. It got us so obsessed with sailing. Selling Little Button is sad, but it's also really exciting because we can't upgrade to a bigger boat until we get rid of our little boat. As far as if you are interested in learning how to sail, if you're interested in teaching yourself how to sail, I would definitely recommend a smaller boat. The 15 footer for two people was great. It is very limiting of what you can do and what you can learn, just because it's a tiny little boat. There's only so much on it. So let's go outside and I will show you how to rig up the boat. So here is the Little Button. It is a Coronado 15. The previous owners put this little wood block because we have a little motor that you can hook up right here. But we never use it because we just use the oars if we lose wind and we have to get back to shore. So here's a little quick overview. The mast is aluminum, so it's super light and he can put it up by himself. I'm just gonna help put the forestay up. I'm gonna put the foot of the mast in this little groove and he's just gonna tilt it up. Normally I do help on this part, but as long as you have the footing in there, you just tilt it up and it's pretty easy, right? So right here we have a little clip where the forestay hooks up. It goes about right there. Trying not to drop the camera. And that is it. Now the mast is up. The shrouds don't move. They're just permanently hooked up right there. The shrouds are for the most part permanent, but you can take these off or tighten them or loosen them. The previous owner just have these little PVC pipes so it doesn't hit the line on the wire. This little baby shackle we use for the jib. This is for when we trailer it. That's normally hooked up, but we just had the cover on it, so that's off. We have the boom laying right here. If you saw, it just slides into this little part right here. So it's a little windy, so I'm not gonna put the sails up, but these tracks run across the boom. Part of the sail goes into the tract on this, and then you feed it through the tract on the boom. This part hooks up to the sail, and then you can tighten it with that one. All the lines are color-coded, and that was just because of the previous owner. But the white one is for the sheets, just to move the boom back and forth, whichever the way the wind is coming. The orange one is a boom vang. You just put tension on it, so it's not like jumping up and down if you hit waves. The blue is for the jib halyard, and then the white one is for the mainsail halyard, so you pull it up that way. So this little portion is mostly just for the jib. On the side, on both sides, there's this eye. You can see my finger is poking through, that you feed a line through for the jib, and it goes through here. This bar right here is the sheet traveler. We actually haven't moved it just because we haven't had to, but this just allows it to go back and forth. The yellow line is to put this centerboard down. It's obviously up because it's on the trailer, but once you put it in the water, you want to put it all the way down so you have full stability and you can move it. Up forward, we have a little companionway where we put like our dry bag with like jacket, our car keys, there's a few oars. Fenders are usually kept up there. This little guy right here is just what the mast lays on when it's on the trailer, but you actually just take it out and then put the tiller on right there. And that, for the most part, is the entire boat tour. So hopefully this will help you out if you have a similar boat, or if you're learning to sail and you have absolutely no idea what you're doing, which is what we were doing. I definitely recommend dry sailing or just practicing in your driveway just to get familiar with the boat. But little button, that's our boat. Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Don't mind the mess if you can see it. There's a giant pile of laundry that I need to put away, but I'm actually just getting ready to like pack up and go see my parents. If you follow me on Instagram, you already know that my husband and I have been teaching ourselves how to sail. That's kind of how we've been getting through the weird year that this is. We have a really tiny little baby boat. It's a 15 footer, and my parents have a 24 footer, so we are going to go see how it is to sail on a bigger boat. By the time you see this video, Little Button actually is already gone. We already sold it. So I'm just gathering a few things, and I have this package that I've been saving because I wanted to open it. So today's video is actually sponsored by Itasca Outfitters. It's a new startup company. So I'm really excited. I did not open this. That is how you spell it. Ooh, cool. Do not have anything this color. That's pretty fun. It has this little fish. I really like this color. I don't have anything this color for these dry fits SPF kind of shirts. So I really like shirts like these because they are actually SPF. I think they're super, super convenient for the summer especially, but even more so if you're into fishing or if you're into sailing or boating or jet skiing, or I don't know, if you just burn easily, just because this one is actually SPF 50. It's actually a really soft material and it's like that really nice dry fitting. So I like shirts like this because of a few reasons. One, I burn easily. I burn very easily. I'm very pasty and I don't really tan. I pretty much just lobster up and then peel and then go back to being white and pasty. So sunscreen and SPF type of shirts like this is very crucial for me. Even if you tan easily and you just never burn, if you have tattoos, you should cover it up or you should put sunscreen on because it's going to fade, or wear a shirt like this so you don't age or get sunspots or get wrinkles. So I have a few shirts like these, the SPF kind, and I definitely recommend them. And you don't have to be sailing. You don't have to be like out on a hike or like doing something fun, even if you're just outside mowing your yard. So I'm definitely bringing this for our next little sailing trip. So thank you again, Itasca Outfitters, for sponsoring this video. Again, I will have everything linked down below. I will have this shirt linked down below if you want to check them out. And I'm going to continue getting ready and continue packing up the car.